Hi guys! In this video, we're going to spice up the riser we added in the last video by adding some effects to it. Let's open up the mixer with F9. Now, as you can see, we currently have two tracks in the mixer that make up the riser, and we probably want to apply the same effect to both of them. There's a few ways we could do this. One option would be to go into the channel rack and set both instruments to the same mixer channel. Then we can apply effects to both of them on that channel. But instead, we're going to create what is called a bus or group. Right now, our risers are routed directly to the master channel in the mixer. You can see this by clicking on the channel in the mixer. The arrow shows us that the master is receiving input from the current track, and the knob value is how loud it is. What we're going to do is route both of the riser channels to a third channel, the bus, and then route that bus to the master channel. We'll be putting the effects on our bus so they are applied to both riser channels together. First, we need to select the channels we want to route. Hold down Control and click and drag across the two channels in the mixer to select them. The green box indicates that they are selected. Look for a free track in the mixer. Because we've named most of our tracks, we can be pretty sure that Insert 14 is free. Right-click at the bottom of channel 14 and select Route to this track only. This will remove the link to the master channel automatically. See how the arrow has disappeared from the master, but there's now one on channel 14? We don't want the individual riser channels going to the master. We first want to add effects on the new bus channel, and then send the audio with effects on it to the master. Click on channel 14 and hit F2 to rename it. I'm going to call it Riser Bus. I'm going to set the color to green simply because I always color my buses green. That way, I can identify them immediately in a busy mixer. You can of course choose any color you like. Note how channel 14 is routed to the master. Now, I'm not happy that this new mixer channel is far away from the channels being sent to it, so I'm going to move it to the left. I can do that using Alt and the left cursor key. Alt and right cursor key will move tracks in the other direction. Click in one of the effect slots and open Fruity Delay 2. This is a nice simple delay plugin that will do just what we want. There's also Delay 3, but that is overkill for our needs. By default, the time is set to 3 steps, which is fine for our needs, but you can set the delay time to a different number of steps by right-clicking it. If you drag the knob manually, you can set it to other values, but I generally like having my delays synchronized to the beat of the song. The little marker around the knobs will turn orange when synchronized to the beat. The volume knob on the input will affect the volume of the echoes. Use the volume knob on the feedback to increase the amount of the delayed signal that is sent back through the delay again. The higher you set this, the longer your delays will ring out. You can hear this best if I select the last bar of the intro and the first bar of the main section of the song and loop the two bars. If I switch to the mixer and Alt-click on the bus channel's solo button, I will solo everything in the mixer except for that channel and the channels routed to it. We can use this to solo the riser and listen to it on its own. You can hear how the echoes ring out after the bar ends. If I turn down the feedback volume, the echoes die out much quicker. Let's also add some reverb. In the mixer channel, click an effect slot below the delay. This will make sure that the reverb is applied after the delay. The order that you put your effects can sometimes have a big effect on the overall sound. If you've put the delay in the last slot and need to move it up, move your mouse cursor over the effect and use the scroll wheel to move it up and down. You can also move effects using the menu, but this is a lot slower. We're going to use Fruity Convolver as our reverb. Let's add the effect. I'm going to turn up the delay a little. This is the delay before the reverb first kicks in. Something around 20 to 30 milliseconds is probably fine. The wet knob determines how much reverb we hear. If I turn it down, the sound will get a lot thinner. If I turn it up, it starts sounding quite alien. Find a sweet spot where you like the sound. The waveform you can see is actually a recording, known as an impulse response. The included presets use different impulse responses, and you can also download your own to use in Convolver. You might want to try out some of the presets and find one you like. Remember to solo the riser if you want to be able to better hear what is happening to the sound. That just about wraps it up for this video, but before we end, a couple of quick words about buses. Going back to the mixer with F9, we can use the bus to change the overall volume of the riser. If we turn it down, we turn down both the noise and the pitch riser. We can adjust the mix between the two riser components with the volume faders on their individual channels. So use the individual channel volumes to blend the inputs going to the bus, and use the bus fader to balance the riser's volume within your mix. If we find ourselves needing to turn the riser up or down later, we can do that with a single slider. In the next video, we'll look at extending our track further and adding a new section to the main body of the track. See you there.